Hello everyone and welcome to the course of 5G and beyond technologies. So in this course we are going to discuss about 5G and its beyond technologies. So in this we are going to discuss about very first is release 17 proposed architecture. So let's discuss about release 17 proposed architecture. So the 5GS architecture, it builds on cloud native foundation by means of the service based architecture in the 5G core. This 5G core also provides the architectural agility because it introduced the compute storage split. So there is a split of the computing and storage, and it is the enablers for 1:N redundancy for control plane resiliency. It helps in efficient transaction processing and operational efficiency. Now, if we talk about the previous release, which is release 17, it focuses on IoT related enhancement like ultra reliable low latency communication, TSC, NPNs, wireless and wireline convergent, and full system resiliency. Now that means the release 17 architecture, it will provide the further enhancements for analytic powered networks, and it are the enablers for the network automation. So there is a support for proximity services, and we have multicast and broadcast architecture in this. Under release 17 proposed architecture, there is enhancement to support the edge computing architecture, enhancements to support the IIoT framework, and support for the various NTNs and drones. So let's discuss about analytic powered networks. Release 15 and release 17, they specify the framework for data collection and data analytics in the 5GS because it introduced the network data analytic function, which is known as NDWAF. So this will pave the way forward towards utilizing the full potential of artificial intelligence and machine learning techniques so that they can realize the network automation with little human interaction. There are more localized cognitive self-management for every radio access point and edge cloud entity which is required in this. So in analytics powered networks, the network management moves to higher level abstractions for the cluster of nodes. So here the NWDAF, it plays a key role as a functional entity. It collects the KPIs and other information about different network domains and uses them. It uses them to provide analytic based statics to 5G core network functions like PCF. Next is enhancement for verticals and industrial IoTs. So support for end-to-end IIoT in 5GS, it is based on set of enabling features like support for time-sensitive communication, private networks, support for 5G LAN type services, and enhanced location services. In release 16, TSC support is based on integration with the IEEE time-sensitive networking, which is known as TSN. TSN set of standards, and these are developed by TSN task force or group. This TSC is basically a communication service which supports communication with high reliability and availability. This architectural model, it considers the 5G system as a bridge of integration of 5G system with TSN operating network. Here, the support of NPNs include enhancements for network deployment and which are dedicated to specific use cases like IIoT, and it is fully isolated to allow only authorized subscribers to camp on a network. The deployments are basically of two types. We have standalone NPN and public network integrated NPN. So what is the difference? Like standalone NPN related enhancement, it includes introduction of a network identifier for a unique network identification. And next one is public network integrated NPN related enhancement with support for closed access groups, CAGs, access control and cell selection using CAGs. It is proposed that support for NPN will further extended in Release 17. And the support for emergency services will also be introduced for standalone NPN deployment, as well as the support for onboarding and provisioning of non-public networks. Here, the enhancements to support 5G LAN services and enable the optimized routing and local switching within the 5G system for user equipment to user equipment communication. In industrial environment, different 5G LAN groups could be maintained and managed for different device types. This location services for IIoT need to meet requirements on accuracy. Next is expansion on mobility and altitude. One of the main drivers for 5G evolution is to expand the reach of mobile connectivity beyond the current boundaries. Enhancements for NTNs include both satellite and high altitude platform station HAPS. Here, the connectivity and control of unmanned aerial vehicles, UAVs. It includes identification, tracking, and authentication. Next is proximity services. Now, support for proximity services is beneficial both for public safety and commercial services. So, it is expected to introduce support for both proxy discovery and communication. In case of public safety, it is essential to support this discovery and communication when the user equipment is out of coverage. MBMS as multimedia broadcast and multicast services. Support for MBMS will be introduced for new radio mainly for public safety use cases, vehicle-to-X applications and railways. These use cases require broadcasting multicasting over an area potentially wider than a single cell. It is expected to employ the independent broadcasting in each cell rather than requiring support for wide area single frequency network operation. Edge computing enhancements. The 5G system in the release 15 introducing a strong foundation to enable edge computing by means of support for local UPF selection or reselection concurrent access to local and central data networks. So, it provides enhancement to improve coordination of mobility procedures with the application. So, introduction of further enhancement to improve the coordination of these procedures with the applications. Security evolution. 5G networks ensure privacy of their users, confidentiality protection, integrity, transport and protection against attacks, because it can affect availability, integrity of network and confidentiality of the stored data. So new security features will also help industry segments also. Support for MPN with new authentication schemes will drive the 5G adoption in these environments. The different security feature will help the massive IoT adoption. Network slice selection assistant information for slice access can be protected. And security for duplicated transmission is expected to provide the support for new apps like medical imaging. Thank you.